Hi, I'm Clint Grandel, manufacturing engineer at QA1 in Lakeville, Minnesota. We're out on the manufacturing floor today, and I'm going to take you on a quick tour of the manufacturing processes for our adjustable shock family. Many of the components in each adjustable shock start off right here as raw material. We apply many manufacturing processes, including machining, assembly, and inspection, to ensure that each component can be made in a manner that will result in a high quality, durable, and consistent shock. In the CNC department at QA1, we run about a dozen machines around the clock. These machines support and build various components for our shock absorbers, including pistons, glands, bodies, and bases. This machine right here creates our single and double adjustable bases. A base starts off on one end as raw, solid bar stock. It goes through a CNC process and comes out the other end as a finished component that's ready to leave our building for plating. In order to keep our team members focused on the technical aspects of manufacturing, we're constantly looking for opportunities for automation. Here's an example where we have a robotic arm that is simply just unloading a machine. It picks a part off a conveyor belt and puts it into a tote. QA1 is constantly investing in quality. A good example of that are the machines we buy and their capabilities. For example, this machine here has internal probing capabilities where it can measure a part after being machined and make slight adjustments. In order to validate our machining processes, we have a fully staffed quality department with many pieces of state-of-the-art equipment, including various CMMs, optical measurement devices, and highly trained inspection staff. An important step after the machining process is plating. QA1 uses various plating techniques to make sure your part will keep looking great for years to come in the harshest environments. After the plating process, critical dimensions are re-inspected to make sure nothing's changed. Once those parts are inspected, they move their way over here into our sub-assembly stations where we'll be building piston assemblies, gland assemblies, and our adjustable base assemblies. Each one of these sub-assemblies will be consumed today into a shock ready to leave the building by this afternoon. In conjunction with the adjustable base, the piston rod assembly controls the dampening in the shock, dictates the stroke of the shock, and provides a linear bearing which minimizes binding and side loading in the shock. Behind us is our wet assembly line. This is where the sub-assemblies come together with the major shock components to build a shock. Once a shock is born, we send it through an automated filling station which pumps oil into the shock and removes all air. Once that process is done, we add a serialized closure nut. This gives us maximum traceability when we run each shock across our dynos. Our shock dynos guarantee the compression and rebound characteristics of that specific shock meet your requirements. After a shock is built and tested, it goes through an automated wash system. This wash system removes manufacturing residues, ensuring that when it shows up into your hands, it's clean and ready to be installed in your vehicle. After the wash process, the shocks go through a final assembly where various components are added to accommodate your mounting configuration. After final assembly, each shock goes to a packaging station. This is where it's boxed with various mounting hardware, literature, our limited lifetime warranty card, a QA1 sticker, and at this point the box is closed and it could be shipped. But because of our continuous commitment to improving quality, we measure each shock in its final packaging and compare it to a known value. This ensures when the shock shows up at your doorstep, it has everything it needs. Once these shocks are in your hand, it's important to remember that we have a robust technical library online that can answer many of your questions, as well as a tech service team made up of enthusiasts just like you who sit about 100 feet away from where every one of these shocks are built. Thanks for checking out QA1 and learning how our shocks are built right here in Lakeville, Minnesota. Feel free to watch our other videos on YouTube, find our tech tips at QA1.net, and come find us on social media.